What's up, everyone in the cycling community? I'll be talking in English for now because I'm not really comfortable talking in Filipino, especially I just really like English. Basically, I was able to talk in Filipino for the previous video, but the thing is, I'm a lot more comfortable and I feel like I'm me if I'm starting to talk in English. So right now, I'm gonna do this video in English, alright? And probably in the first thing that you're probably asking me when you saw the previous videos that I uploaded, and yeah, I know, I'm still not as famous as the other YouTubers in the cycling community. But think about it, some of you were able to see the previous videos that I uploaded. So yeah, I have a cross-country bike. I really love this bike. It's my favorite bike ever since that I got this. And yeah, mountain bikes are for mountain bikes. Basically, mountain bikes should have a handlebar, but I prefer road bike. Dropbars. Alright, so that's actually a really long story why I did this, but I would like to tell you guys how it feels like to have a monster gravel. Yeah. Alright, so basically the reason why I transferred or converted my handlebar mountain bike into a dropbar mountain bike, it's because of the hand positioning. That's the very first thing that's why I did this, alright? Well, in a handlebar, either it's a straight bar, it's a riser bar, or it's a BMX handlebar, your hands are normally positioned in a knuckle position. Alright, so when it comes to long rides, probably I really need to ride more so that my hands get used to the feeling and be able to withstand the pain in the longer runs in the next future rides. But the thing is, it's always been my complaint. Well, basically, I was able to ride 3 months consistently, probably 4 months consistently without any issues, but there's just one hiccup that's having or that's really ruining the feeling, the experience, at least for me. My hands are always getting numb if I am in a normal mountain bike handlebar position, and that's the reason why I've always thought I'd do a drop bar position, you know, because the position of your hand with the drop bars, or let's say the road bike handlebars, it's on the most natural position when you're walking, when you're running, when you're jumping, you know, it's always positioned this way, basically this way. Yeah, so road bike drop bars or road bike handlebars, it actually provides you better hand positions, more hand option positions, whatever those things are. That's the main concern. All right so the second thing why I converted my mountain bike again, all right, it's because, well, cross-country bikes are cross-country bikes. They are the race cars of the mountain biking world, all right? So basically, if you're going to compare this to a automotive world, right? They're like the rally cars, all right? Somehow, I think. Or like, they are like the indie rally car kind of thing. Basically, they're like rally car. Why? Rally cars are light. Rally cars are modified for race competitions. And yeah, they race against each other. When it comes to cross-country bikes, they run on multiple terrains just like rally cars. They run on concrete, they run on asphalt, they run on tarmac, they run on gravel, they also run on mud, mountains, and even big ramps. So basically, cross-country bikes can also handle big ramps, but not like how enduro and downhill bikes would do. But yeah, they still jump, alright? So they're like the rally cars of the automotive world, and they are meant for racing. Cross-country geometry are meant for racing, especially if your frame have a really sturdy-looking dropouts. You know, this kind of thick dropouts, sometimes it's not enough, I think. It needs to be a little more thicker. But yeah, this one would work, especially if you're gonna race it. Alright? So, why not add a drop handlebar or a gravel handlebar, gravel drop bar on a cross-country bike? Why? Well, for aero, off-road. Make sense? Probably. It should make sense. It's a race car. It's a race bike, man. It's a race bike. You need a race handlebar. But basically, it just offers a lot more hand position for me, and that works, especially the aero position. I mean, I can do descents faster the way I really wanted to. You want to go fast? Why not do aero? Basically, I want this bike to be kind of a gravel-esque mountain bike. Like, it's a road bike-ish mountain bike. So it's not a bad thing for me. Another thing, the reason why I did this to my bike, well, basically, mountain bikes and road bikes are similar, especially back in the era when they were invented. Road bikes were the first bikes to be invented, followed by the mountain bike that came from road bikes. So the idea here in my position is, I want a road bike look, but I prefer to build the design of a mountain bike. So basically, I'm looking for the durability of a mountain bike, hence the looks and the handling, the performance of a drop bar road bike. So basically, why not create it and put it on some hardtail front suspension mountain bike with a drop bar on hand? Why not? So it serves the purpose that I would want. And basically, to all those people telling me, you should do rigid, you should convert your fork to be rigid because suspension fork is dangerous, like it's gonna kill you. But seriously bro, John Tomac did this in 1990 UCI downhill kamikaze event, and he was actually rocking the scene, bro. He's decimating it. So it's not a bad thing to have aerodynamic position going downhills on a freaking off-road. I love feeling frightened biking my bike, so I love this. You don't need to tell me to do rigid. What's the point of going rigid if you're going off-road? I mean, for you to feel the gravel feels. I mean, seriously, bro. You don't need to convert to rigid for you to feel gravel. You're looking for an utmost performance in handling. You're also looking for aerodynamic top speed. Why not have it both? Probably it's not gonna make sense to you guys, but yes, this is a really good build. Even other Americans would agree to have a front suspension on a drop bar mountain bike. Man, face it, you don't need rigid. You don't need rigid. And still, no matter how many times I tell you my reasons why I did this to my bike, it's still your own personal preference, because you don't need rigid. Seriously, you're having a mountain bike and off-road wheels or off-road tires or kind of a recreational classic vintage off-road tires. But the thing is, you need off-road suspension. You don't need rigid. People are gonna tell you, go rigid for you to feel the road, the off-road, the gravel. I mean, bro, this is a mountain bike. Still, it's a mountain bike. It's meant for off-road. Why are you going to take away the off-road capability, the number one off-road capability, aside from the tires? It's the suspension. You had off-road tires, why not add off-road suspension? That is why companies right now are making gravel bikes with full suspension.
When off-road bike brand Niner first teased this full suspension gravel bike, much of the world was in shock, basically. But yeah, here we are 2 years later and the Niner MCR is ready for release. A genuine full suspension gravel bike with 50 millimeters of suspension at the back and 40 millimeters of suspension up front.
Are you late from the news? Gravel bikes are now having front suspension, and some gravel bikes are also having rear suspension right now with just a minimal travel. So why force me to go rigid? Alright, for the main piece of spices and tasty, greatly awesomeness. The feeling of having a dropbar mountain bike is actually exceptional, at least for me. It gives you multiple hand positions, and it gives you way more feel to the bike itself. It makes you feel you're faster, which actually basically, you are really faster. Why? Well, basically your hands are in a much more narrower length compared to a handlebar. Handlebars ranging from 800 or 850, especially considering the 700 above length. I actually have one of those, and I converted it to a drop bar. And this drop bar that I got, it's around 400 millimeter of length. And coming from 760 going down to 400, that's a really massive improvement when it comes to aerodynamic airflow, which actually makes me a lot faster compared to the previous handlebar position that produces a lot of drag. But the advantage of having a handlebar compared to this, it gives you a better leverage when it comes to handling. Unlike this, if you're going off-road, it's gonna terrify the hell out of yourself. You're going to question yourself, why did I convert this mountain bike into a road bike setup? But seriously, we're not here to think about how scary it is. I'm telling you guys, I am the rider. And for me, having a drop bar on a mountain bike, especially what GMB and Dottie said.
I didn't think I'd say it, but it's kind of fun and scary. Just like mountain biking used to be fair.
It's terrifyingly fun. And that's what I always wanted to have. Mountain bikes are just like cars. They're being safer. They're getting safer, safer and safer. They're better. But of course, sometimes being safer doesn't mean it is better. I love the feeling of being frightened, yet enjoying this kind of setup. Overall, the positioning of you riding this kind of bike, it actually overall changes the whole position, the riding position, and doesn't really change the geometry that much, just the riding position. So it's up to you, the rider, if you would want this kind of setup. You can easily do this, but I suggest don't go for Shimano shifters like SDI, or don't go for SRAM double top just yet. Alright? Why? I'm gonna tell you. So the thing is, well, you would want a drop bar, so you would need an SDI. Right? So if you do an SDI, you'd be stuck with the setup for, let's say, a month, because you would feel bad for yourself doing all this hassle, all this trouble just to remove it after you tried it. So the best thing for you to do so, if you really want to try this, there's the very first thing you can do, and that's the corner bar. When we say corner bar, it's kind of a mountain bike setup with this kind of corner for this side, so you can just simply add your mountain bike cockpit to a drop bar-ish handlebar. Corner bars are really made for mountain bikes, so you don't need or you wouldn't require for an STI or a SRAM double tap shifters for it to work, okay? But if you really are committed to this kind of setup, you would want a drop bar itself because it provides you the better grip, in my opinion, compared to a corner bar. Corner bar is kind of a bit narrower than the drops of this gravel drop bar handlebars thing. Alright, then I would really need an STI or a double tap shifter here because it's hard to transfer your hand over and over again just to shift. Seriously. So I'll be looking for budgeted options for the next month, having the shifters here. Shifters and brake levers on all one place and have this area tidy up. You know, clean it, make it look a little bit more better than this one. So yeah, that's how it feels like to ride a drop bar mountain bike. I'm not gonna call it monster gravel anymore. I'm not gonna call it a gravel bike anymore. I'm just gonna call it a drop bar mountain bike because it is the drop bar mountain bike. It's still a mountain bike. So yeah, I'll be including footage and how the road bike, I mean this drop bar mountain bike feels like. Yeah, so yeah, I hope you enjoy the scenery of having drop bars on a mountain bike cruising around Arcovia. I'm actually at the back behind Arcovia, so yeah, I'll be including some certain footages. Yeah. So this is a drop bar mountain bike and we are riding it up. Alright, taking for a spin, I'll show you how it feels like. So yeah, we'll be going through the bike loop around Arcovia. Yeah, so yeah, let me show you how it feels like. And is it fast or is it slower? This is road, so yeah. Sadly, we don't have a bike computer for us to check how much speed we're currently in. But hopefully with this kind of visual, you can see how fast we're going. So I hope I was able to share you certain information about what it feels like to have a monster gravel dropbar mountain bike. And hopefully if you really are planning to get this kind of build or get into this kind of build, I suggest you try so, but of course do it on a budget first. Try to get aerodynamic road bike brake levers and just use an handlebar extension for your shifter before you completely transform it into an STI setup or a double tap shifter. Why? Because you don't want to waste a lot of money of getting a road bike levers just to sell it the next day if you're not happy about it. So yeah, go to this basic cheap ass setup if you really want to try it out. And then if you are convinced that you are better with this kind of setup, that's the time you need to buy the real shifter for the gravel bike setup. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this video and please like, share and subscribe. You can comment if you want to. So yeah, if you want this kind of content, if you want to see this kind of bike and more of the videos, I would like to invite you to subscribe. And I'm gonna create more videos with this because I'm keeping this.